Welcome to Cavendish University, Zambia. My name is James Chola, Dean for the School of Arts, Education and Social Sciences. I'll take you through as a student who is coming for the first time at our physical campus. But in this case, this is a virtual campus, so I expect you to start developing your imaginatory skills in terms of our discussion. The School of Arts, Education and Social Sciences offers the following courses. We have a Bachelor of Arts in Development Studies. We have Bachelor of Arts in Mass Communication and Public Relations. The school offers Bachelor of Social Work. The school also offers a Master's in Development Studies, as well as Master's in Communication and Public Relations. So basically those are the courses that we offer. The courses are offered both on distance, evening and full time. Now in this era of COVID, we are going online, and most of you are getting online education for the first time, and I would like to take this time and opportunity to say online education has got its own challenges, and the university has transformed itself to be the first of its kind in terms of offering online education. What? Maybe the question before I could even go further to explain more about the faculties, why do students drop out of online classes? And often students are unprepared for this unique venture. And the challenges of online varies from the best universities to the worst university. But I think all too often students fail or drop out of online courses because of insufficient preparation for the special challenges and familiar format of online learning. It is for this reason that I've taken this opportunity of my busy schedule to prepare you virtually on how you are going to be conducting your online education. Now, this can be a result of any number of factors. Dropping out of online education could range from your poor reading skills, your poor communication skills, but sometimes your workload schedule because of your busy schedule, which will require therefore time management and knowledge of technology. So preparing students for effective academic computer-mediated communication will enable you to settle correctly in this venture. It is for this reason that these innovative strategies that I shall be discussing will increase your initial and continued success, as well as retention in online classes. Perhaps I would discuss one of the most important points of online education, the effective practices which can be looked at as standards. Ensure that during your online learning, you require both preparation plus follow-ups. What do I mean by preparation and follow-ups? It is not good enough to say I am ready to start the online classes, but it will be important that follow-ups are made. Good practices are retained over a longer period of time. Remember, you have been used to physical classes, and you did that, some of you, for 12 years, from grade 1 to 12. Some of you have done them for the past probably half of your life. You have been physically learning in class. Now you need to learn virtually. And through the systematic and ongoing practice, you begin reinforcing new strategies that will enable you to develop and maintain self-directed learning. Self-directed learning requires correct behavior. For example, time management. If a scheduled class is 10 hours, 10 minutes before 10 hours, you must set your platform. You must, in short, have logged in, waiting for the lecturer. You don't go at 10 hours to start logging in. Some of you in your areas, internet is a problem, so by the time you manage to log in, it will be 10:30, you would have lost out. So welcome to online learning, which will require new discipline in terms of time management. So one of the best practices of online education is time management. Again, I talked about preparing. Preparing means you have also tested your tools. Your laptops are connected, your cables, if you are using cable internet, must be well connected. If you are using your dongles in your offices, they must be working. In short, you must already test that the tools are working for online learning to be effective. Well, another important aspect, and perhaps the most important element, is communication. So what happens? You are in your class, then the computer logs you out. Learners must be capable of communicating effectively, sometimes via text, to inform your lecturer that you have been logged out, your lecture may need to slow down, or your lecture may need to retake the same topic, your lecture need to post what they were teaching. You may also need to develop new knowledge, recording whatever is being discussed in class. A major component, instead of writing, which is an old fashion, I'm not saying you should not be writing, but you will now be recording much more of your classes than writing. So I thought I should take this opportunity as evidence of effective virtual learning. And during this period of orientation, the successful activities that you shall embark on in your curriculum, much of it should be based on what is the best practice. Opportunities for learners to think critically is, how fast can you access the syllabus? How fast can you access the online content that has been recorded, that has been posted? The students who are going to develop these skills of recording, accessing the syllabus, being able to think critically, reflect effectively, and research topics even before the class starts, are likely to succeed in terms of writing the assignment. So again, writing is one of the most essential skills for success in online learning. When I said you should be recording, I did not remove the component of writing. Remember, with the modern technology, we'll be recording. But after you record, try after the class to go and write what you were recording, so that you reinforce your writing skills through peer review. And basically, this forms part of the integral part of the study throughout your academic circle. So welcome to the School of Social Sciences. And the School of Social Sciences would offer you the opportunity to answer your real life questions. Questions that basically should be able to be reflected through your time that you'll be studying with Cavendish and Social Science. Under development studies, with the current scenario, I understand that it will not only prepare you better how to respond to the challenge that we are facing in terms of COVID-19, to be able to go beyond learning in a classroom. How do we respond to the current scenario as development expert? For those who are doing education, it's a big challenge because you will be students learning online. You will also be able to learn how to go and teach others online. So this is the best platform for you, because you will be among the first graduates who are going to develop better skills of how to teach online. Then we have issues now with those doing social sciences, like social work. The current scenario of coronavirus would now require how social scientists, from the social point of view, can help people who are now confined in their homes to deal with their social problem. This is a unique time on how we can develop different skills on how to reach out to those people. And through the studies from social sciences, you'll be able to develop those skills that are necessary in order to address the current social problems. With those that will be doing Mass Communication and Public Relations. What more can we demand from you? It is this moment which is critical, that you develop effective communication skills so that we can be able to communicate to the public about not just the current scenario, but on the future scenarios. Now we are dealing with online communication. Now we are dealing with online education. So it's the right moment. It has come at the right time when student needs not to sit in a classroom to learn, but students who would be innovative are likely more to succeed and find better jobs than those that are likely to continue thinking of a setup of a university as in a classroom seated on desk, but those that can start thinking innovatively. I welcome you again to Cavendish University School of Arts, Education and Social Science, and I look forward to working with you, to seeing you becoming better leaders and future employers rather than future employees. Welcome to Cavendish University. Thank you.
My name is Lee Caleb Malangu, Dean School of Business and Information Technology. Business school is made up of two heads of department, being Mrs. Elizabeth Munengami Ziambo, heading the business section, and Mr. Sinkala Henry, heading the ICT section. In total, we have about 13 programs that we are currently running. We have three MBA programs, being the MBA in HR, MBA in Finance, and the MBA Generic. And the undergraduate programs, we have the following: that is Business, Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Arts in Banking and Finance, Bachelor of Accountancy, Bachelor of Economics. We also have the Bachelor of Information Technology, Bachelor of Science in Computer Sciences. As a school, we are currently the largest at Cavendish University, and I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you all and thank you all for choosing Cavendish as a university of your choice. As they say, success begins at Cavendish, and I can assure you that the decision that you have made makes a difference in your life starting from today. Change begins at Cavendish, and as an institution, we are here to transform the lives into greater lives. There is no better place to be at other than Cavendish University. Let me take this opportunity again to say you're welcome, and any challenges that you might have or face as our students, you are free to see any one of us. The lecturers that are in this school are lecturers that are well experienced, and they are there to ensure that your learning is enabled and you enjoy your work study throughout the 4 years that you'll be here with us. Let me also take this opportunity to state that it is your responsibility to ensure that you put your studies first. Take time to go through your work. Take time to read beyond school coverage. Here, we are simply here to ensure that we produce graduates that are, one, employable, entrepreneurial, and responsible citizens. Allow me to say again that you're welcome, and we wish you the best in your educational journey. Thank you.